budget travel or luxury?
Luxury.
One thing this trip has taught me. Oh, in a word. Come on. Five.
Okay.
Four, three, two. KSV TV. We're really excited because just before our summer holidays, we have somebody who's really, really a travel junkie and a mom who is hosting a fabulous travel show called Mini Me, which is traveling with her daughter around 6 countries, 15 cities, and that is Mini Mathur. So Mini, thank you so much for joining us today. We really look forward to this episode. Exciting travel, unplanned itineraries.
I love making it, and I think it's the perfect day to launch the show as well.
Tell us. How is Mini the mom different from Mini the actor or the TV host?
So I've always believed that the key to a good balance is to be true to all your personas when you're in them. So when I'm working, when I'm here, when I'm hosting a show, when I'm traveling, my focus is on doing the job at hand to the best of my abilities. But I think what's important is for you to be really planned. And me as a mom, I feel works because I plan and pre-plan. So I have their agendas set. I have delegated the right things to the right people. Thankfully, my children are now not toddlers, but when they were, I was working much more than I'm working now. And I just made sure when I was at home, I was not the Mini, the TV host at home.
Were you scared even for a second that, you know, my daughter's my responsibility and I better do a good job of doing this?
I have, but I think my trips with the girls has empowered me to know that I can deal with it. I can handle any crisis.
Now that you say that you don't go to iffy places, can moms really have fun and let their hair loose with their kids, only with their kids?
Absolutely. So I didn't, barring the fact that her biological clock doesn't allow her to stay till, say up till late. But for example, we went to, a place in Tarquinia, which is close to Tuscany, and we've spent a couple of days with this old Italian couple who own a vineyard, and he taught us how to make wine and how it's made and everything. And he said, and it's tradition for all the grandchildren in the family to taste a sip of the new harvest wine. Wow. So, you know, why doesn't your daughter? Your daughter must have it. And she's like, I'm not allowed wine. I said, well, this is Roman tradition, and in Rome we do as Romans do. Take a sip.
Yeah.
And she was super excited. Of course, she tasted it. She said, I don't know how you have this. You know, it's crap. I said, fine, but it's your experience. You know, you know where you had your first sip of wine.
Out of all the 6 countries that you've traveled, which one is your favorite?
Oh my God, this is so difficult because we really did. We did Germany. Okay, let me just tell you a quick part. Right? We started with Munich, then we went to Paris, then we went to Venice, we went to Croatia, Montenegro, Rome, Florence, Marseille, Naples, and Barcelona, and Athens and Mykonos. So each one of them, like you can say,
it's making me feel like so blah right now. It's absolutely. Like
choosing between the devil and the deep sea. No. I think we collectively enjoyed Barcelona the most because
it's a
fun city. But I think what was a surprise was Montenegro. It's a country that not a lot of people travel to, but it's a real hidden gem of the world. And that's where we did this little photography contest on camera. I said, you know, Sairah, I'm going to give you this camera. Go shoot what you like. Let's see whether you see the same things as I do.
Okay.
And we clicked pictures of our own and tried to get one up on each other. And at the end, we got one local Montenegrin to decide who shot his country better. And I won't tell you who won because for that, they'll have to see the episode.
Okay.
But yeah, it was a fun thing to do. And that country really took my breath away. It's a small country that was ravaged by an earthquake not so long ago. But now, just look at how beautiful it is.
Okay.
So, loved it.
Okay. Best food on the trip because you're such a foodie. Is Sairah a foodie or she's
busy? Oh my God. So she is a bit of a... aloo paratha eater, but
she's a mathur,
but mathurs also experimented with it. She loves home food.
Mm-hmm.
However, my son is a big foodie, but he wasn't on the trip with her. But when she is traveling with him, she tries to be brave and experiment. And once she got on, then by the end of it, she was eating tapas and she was eating paella, and yeah, she did good. This girl, she's 7, but she was quite brave.
Is Mini the one who like packs the world with her and takes it, or she just like packs and just gets on a holiday?
So as far as packing is concerned, I'm very particular about packing for the kids. So if they're traveling with me, I'll take 2 days to put every damn thing that they need in it because I don't want to be held with, where is my blankie?
How has your relationship really changed with your daughter after your travel?
what she's come back with is looking at me, you know, I haven't let go of any parental authority, but the lines need to be blurred for them to relate to you. And I think what she saw of me was somebody who was not afraid to say I'm afraid, scared to try something new. We got lost, we've been in lots of crisis, but she saw me deal with it. And children lead by example.
Yeah. What was the plan? You guys got your tickets, passport, currency in place, and then are you like a planned traveler, or are you like, okay, I'm just gonna go there and figure out?
So I do a lot of insane amounts of research before I travel to a place, because that's one of the things that attracts me to a place. You know, it's almost comical, from the population of a place to the topography and what happens, what's the weather, what is the cultural scene like, is there a festival, would it be a full moon night, is there something happening? I do all of that, and then I book my tickets and I make sure that the place I'm staying is critical to, you know, I like staying in central local places, okay? I don't like to stay in the heart of the touristy center, but somewhere where a lot of locals reside, a concentration of them. So I book all of that, I plan that, and I have some standard checklist in my mind saying, okay, this is a must-do, this is a must-do. But the rest, I leave it open to. And I tell everyone who travels, keep a little room for improvisation on your trip.
Okay, now that, you've obviously done this travel, how has her concept of budget, luxury, because I know you said that you like living in youth hostels, you've done luxury stays with her, you've traveled multiple modes of transport with her. You feel like you've inculcated a sense of value in her, because obviously she comes from a very privileged background, so does she understand now that, listen, this costs money, we just paid $2 for the hot dog, or we paid $2 for it?
We did this exercise, I'd just like to say that yes, she's one of the blessed few who doesn't have to figure out. But as a mother, I don't believe in raising my children as, oh my God, you can buy what you want and take what you want. I insist to the detriment of how they look at me as a person. They think I'm always planning for doomsday, but I always make sure that they know what it is to be getting a secondhand iPhone. I mean, they make fun of me and say, you know, this is what it costs. This is what somebody earns in a year, and this is what they have to do for it. So be thankful that you've got this.
Thank you so much, all of you, for tuning in. And Mini, thank you so much. It's been an absolute pleasure.
This has been like a chat with our old friend. So thank you. And thank you for tuning in and watching. Remember to watch my show, Mini Me, TLC, Fridays, 9 p.m. It starts on the 9th. It's about girls who travel, and you must do. And thank you for joining us.
And every time that you travel with your girls, please don't forget hashtag girls who travel.
And Mini Me.
And Mini Me.
Bye, see you soon.
For more recipes, conversation, DIYs for kids, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you never miss a video from kidsstoppress.com.